Hello, my dear friends. As you know, now many schools are opening for in-person classes, and kids are required to have face masks during their at school. This is why in this project we will make very thin, just one layer, cotton breathable face masks that can be used by your children at school for many hours. So for this project you will need cotton breathable 100% cotton fabric. You will need also elastics. You can use just white, it's fine also. You will need your sewing machine, your small ironing station, and of course scissors. That's it. And also, if you would like, if you will make also a few masks at the same time, like I will make now four, for example, and you see, you will probably would like to use the kind of the same colors pattern, so you can use the same thread color for all your masks, what you're making. Okay, so let's cut them. So first of all, you will need to fold them all together. Check also the pattern if you want to make them, you know, one certain direction. Okay, so now we're gonna cut this like rectangle. I will make 7 by 8 inches or 20 by 18 centimeters. Also, this is approximately for children like 7, 8, 9 years old. If your child is smaller, you can also, you see, adjust to make it smaller by 1 centimeter or half of an inch, one side and one side smaller. Or if your child is bigger, like 12 or 14, it's close to adult size, so you can add even more little bit, like 1 centimeter here, 1 centimeter here, a half of an inch here and there. So make sure that all layers are under your pattern. Okay, and trace it. The next step, we will use our iron. Okay, so what we will iron long side. Like you can always double check, okay, this is a longer, this is a shorter. So shorter will be going towards to the ears, and this will be top and bottom. So top and bottom, we need to iron like 1/4 of an inch. You can use a little bit steam at the end, and 1/4 of an inch again. And second side. Okay, and you repeat the same on all your four masks. Now we're gonna stitch. So how we stitch it, I will use as a direction, I will use this, you see the distance between feed dogs. So I will direct my folding line to this like small like a hole over here. Now we do other side. Okay. That's it. This way you save a lot of time. Okay, now you just cut it between. The next step, what we will do, you simply fold your mask a half. In a half of this distance, we will stitch like a very small seam, like 2 centimeters long, or like about 3/4 of an inch. Reverse on the both sides, here and here, in the beginning and at the end. And the other side. Like that, okay? Other way how you can do it, you can fold it a half again. In the middle of this, you take it also, you see, a half, so you basically fold these sides together, you see? And you will stitch each distance a half here and a half this small distance. Also 2 centimeters long. This way, when we finish it, it'll be looking a little bit different. We will have 2 folds, one here, one there. I will make 2 this way and 2 this way. So now we need to iron these sides. So let's go to the ironing station. Okay, so when we iron, we just fold these our folds. You see, basically like a half. In the center of our fabric, we just fold towards to our seam line. Like that, and we just press it here. Press it other side. Through all your mask. Then we need to fold like 1/4 of an inch, kind of like here we did one time iron. And second time we fold more like a 1/2 of an inch. Okay, this way. Now we're gonna stitch all the sides. We will stitch now, we will use 10 or like first measurements what you have in your metal plastin. We will stitch it little like wider, so wide enough so you can pull after elastic through this. You see, you can pull it through, okay?
Also, here in the beginning at the end, don't forget to make good reverse stitching. So backwards. And as usually I use a little bit, you see, I pull the threads a little bit forward, so to help machine pull the beginning of the fabric over here. Just few stitches and after it's good. It can go by itself. So as you can see also, I'm, while stitching, I'm pulling a little bit like this way to open a little bit these folds here and here. So it will be much easier to open when you use it on face. So fold it and you see it's kind of goes like that naturally. So I'm not pushing it back. I'm just keeping it in this position, like a little bit open position. Okay, so let's do all of them. Now we turn and do it other sides.
Okay, now we cut in between. That's it. Okay, now what we need to do, we need to cut our elastic. So I will cut 25 centimeters. This will be like about 10 inches long. Also, you can cut it all of them at once. So you take all your elastic, what you need to cut, you take it together and you measure 10 inches. Yeah. Okay, so now you will need like that special hook. If you don't have it, you can use just regular safety pin. For example, yeah, you can just pin it like that and pull it through. Like for example, let's say this softer, like that. Go with the pin, but also, you see, possible. Okay, and after you just open it. If you have this special hook, it will be just much easier. So, if you don't have, I would definitely advise you to have one. So you come through, you hook it, hold it, and you pull it through. See, easy. That's it, so you can adjust it on your child's ears and just tie it. So basically, this one and this, they have the same like width. Just this has two fold, this has one fold. And also when you adjust on the face of your child, it will be more gathered here and much more like shaped here. You see, like rounded. This will be the same. Okay, my dears. So easy, fast, quick project. I will put this in the description or to this video, the sizes, what I use. And also you can always adjust it, as I told, a little bit wider or smaller. I can a little bit show you how it will look like, but kid's face, of course, it's smaller, but actually opening goes very straight in the bottom and the top. So I hope you like this video, and let me know if you have any questions, and let me know maybe some different adjustments you made. Also, would like to hear about that. And that's it. Looking forward to see you in my next video. See you soon. Bye bye, and good luck with your sewing projects.